With the Pope Tech Instructor Accessibility Guide installed, I can run this on any page with the WYSIWYG editor inside of the Canvas LMS. There is now the Pope Tech Accessibility Guide button, and when I run it, I get immediate feedback on the accessibility of my page. In this case, we have 8 accessibility errors and 6 accessibility alerts or things that are highly suspicious. This is built off of the Wave engine. If you're familiar with the Wave engine, you'll be familiar with the icons and results from within the Pope Tech Accessibility Guide. Inside of the guide, results are organized by categories, such as images and links, text and contrast, headings, tables and lists, and documents. So let's drill into a few of these. In this example, we have 5 images that do not have alternative text. We can go into these and click on any of these to jump to these within the Canvas content. We also have text that instructs us what to do. In this case, add alternative text that accurately and succinctly presents the content of the image and function of the link. I can fix the alternative text simply by typing it in. I can also mark it as decorative. I am hitting enter and using the keyboard. I can also hit the apply button, and I'm going through and adding the alternative text on these images. Now that we fixed them, we're alerted that all instances of linked image missing alternative text have been fixed. And we have the chance now to go to the next result, which is empty link. A lot of times in Canvas, links are just added redundantly, and so we could either add the text if there should be a link or simply remove the link to fix the accessibility issue. The accessibility guide alerts us to things such as click here or more, suspicious link text. So let's update this to be take the quiz. When we hit apply, it updates in the content, and with the guide open, I can go and edit my content to not have the text twice. And we have now fixed that issue. Along with the errors and alerts for images and links, there are features. And these are things that can be good if used correctly, and we have the chance to review all of our images' alternative text. In this case, these are the ones that we just fixed, and they are now correct. So let's go to text and contrast. From within text and contrast, we can view all contrast errors and see and fix them simply by moving them darker until we get the green pass and the words pass, and then hit apply to apply these changes. Very small text with a default to 12 pixels. Current is 8 pixels for this word marketing. Hit apply, it's now made it bigger. And on any category that has no errors, we give feedback for the instructor, letting them know that there are no detectable accessibility issues, but that doesn't mean that their accessibility stops there. They should do things like simple language, do not rely on color alone to convey meaning, and other accessibility tips related to the text and contrast category. Headings, we can do things like remove empty headings. These are things often added by Canvas, added by Canvas users that are editing. There's a full heading outline. And again, we can click on any of these icons and it will jump us to the content in Canvas. In this case, these probably shouldn't be headings, so we're going to edit them inside of Canvas, make them paragraphs, and then rescan. And we have now a heading outline, and we can update this to be a proper heading outline with H2s. With the headings fixed, let's go to tables and lists, layout table, and we have the opportunity to review a layout table. Inside of Canvas, in order to make a true data table, you would have to click on a cell and then go to table, cell, cell properties, cell type, header cell, and then set the correct scope of row column. Row or column, row group, column group. Very difficult for instructors to do and hard to teach and get accurate. And with the accessibility guide, we can simply set the first row as header and the first column as header and hit apply, and we have an accessible data table. We also here bring things to the attention of the editor. Things such as lists. These aren't errors or alerts, but it's a chance to review your lists and make sure there aren't additional lists such as, you know, where they manually typed 1, 2, or 3. The accessibility guide brings documents to the attention. It doesn't scan them for accessibility, but it does bring them to the attention, and to ensure that they're natively accessible, ideally use HTML, and if it's required, to specify that it is a PDF in the link. So we're able to apply that. Now for each of these results, if an instructor's not sure, they can click help. And it will give guidance on what it means, why it matters, how to fix it, the algorithm in English, and the relevant standards and guidelines. On the result for images, there's also examples. And more examples will be added for other results. And in this example, it gives an example of a good alternative text, one that would be very difficult if it's lots of data, where it probably should just be converted to data table, a decorative image, or an image that has the same text right by it, and there's the opportunity to mark it as decorative to not have redundant alternative text. And on the image as well, you can click back to the documentation and view the same what it means, why it matters, how to fix it, standards and guidelines. There is also an overall help, where an email can be sent to any email address at the Canvas Accessibility Coordinator at the institution, and with a message, and also has guidance on how to use the accessibility guide.